Hey, welcome to Film Fury. My name is Victor Lucas, and my buddy Johnny Millennium could not join me to go and see The Commuter. This is a January movie. Let's put a little asterisk beside that. Starring Liam Neeson. And so right away, the warning flags go out. Oh my God, is this going to be a crap, sort of just disposed of January release? This is directed by Collet-Serra. It's another thriller starring Liam Neeson. These guys have collaborated before. Collet-Serra and Liam Neeson have done a bunch of movies together. And this is Liam Neeson in kind of familiar territory. He is an old guy who can still kick some serious ass. He's playing an insurance broker, somebody that sells insurance to families. But he's a retired cop, of course. And so he has kind of got this perfect life in the suburbs of New York City. He's married to Elizabeth McGovern. They have a college-age kid. They're setting themselves up to, you know, pay for his very expensive tuition. And they've got a couple of houses or something. And they've, you know, they've got a decent life. But on this fateful day, on one of his commutes, which I think was effectively kind of shown off at the beginning of the movie, the Groundhog Day sameness of Liam Neeson heading to work, they intercut a bunch of sequences in there, lots of different conversations from different days and lots of different commutes to kind of set up the routine that Liam Neeson is going through in his life. But on one fateful day, which is the day this movie takes place, he gets fired from his job and all hell breaks loose. He jumps onto the train. The very mysterious Vera Farmiga, who is also another great actor and another co-star in this well-cast picture, actually. Sam Neill is in this thing, Patrick Wilson, Jonathan Banks from Breaking Bad, some familiar faces, and also some great character and supporting actors in this thing. I was actually pleasantly surprised by everybody's performance. But Vera Farmiga makes Liam Neeson an offer he can't refuse. He's got to do this kind of shady thing, and he's going to get a bunch of money. But of course, his morality comes into play, and he starts to question it. And he, instead of just doing exactly what he's asked, starts to kind of break down the mystery and figure out why he was asked to do this, with some great jeopardy threatened towards him and also his family. But this is Liam Neeson, and this guy knows how to kick some ass and get the job done. And so, no surprise, he's probably going to do that in this movie, because he does that in every movie that he's in. So basically what we see is, you know, 90 minutes of predictability. But Collet-Serra is a pretty good filmmaker. He did The Shallows last year with Blake Lively, which was all about a shark chasing Blake Lively. And I actually really dug that movie. And he does a lot with a little. You know, he's got kind of a confined space, and he can move the camera around in some pretty effective ways. There are some CG sequences in here, some pretty big ones, and I'm not going to spoil why. And they're a little bit cheesy, but for the most part, everything is kind of handled optically, with the camera sort of moving effectively, and some really nice tight shots on characters and on pieces of the train, because the train is basically another character in this movie. We're on the train for most of it. But it, you know, good angles, even in these kind of hokey fight sequences, but everybody tries, you know, led by Collet-Serra, who does try to make this confined space an interesting one for us. There is a disposability about this picture, mostly because we've seen Liam Neeson take this role, this almost exact same role, so many different times before. But it doesn't go down unpleasantly. You know, it was a fun escape, and I don't know if I'm just being, you know, a little generous because I'm still in post-holiday bliss or not, but I was entertained. I wasn't transported. I wasn't blown away, which sounds like the title of Liam Neeson's next movie. But I had a pretty good time. You know, Liam Neeson is, say what you will about his career choices, he's generally fun to watch in everything that he does. And if he's an ass-kicking older Liam Neeson, even though it's kind of starting to become a little less believable, it's still kind of fun to watch. He's good at what he does. And so, you know, you watch this mystery unfold, and you watch some people get beat up. You watch some exciting-ish action pieces on the train. And you come away and you go, well, I forgot the whole plot of that movie, but I still had a pretty good time. And that basically, that kind of sums up my experience with this. It's not a complete waste of time. If you need an escape to go to the theaters, to go and check something out, you know, you want to get away from your family for a bit or whatever, you might have a pretty good time with The Commuter. I had a pretty good time with The Commuter. I'm going to give it a 6.5 out of 10.